Hello friend Uchi YAS, how are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose we have started MCQ series of different topics like Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern India, Environment and Ecology, Polity, Geography, etc. So we have a proper timetable on which we upload these videos. So already the timetable video is in the playlist, every playlist of our channel that we have created. So now we are covering the lecture number 19 of Ancient India. Already 18 lectures have been covered. So what we do in this series, we daily cover 5 questions of each topic. For example, we are on the lecture number 19 of your Ancient India, and then we will cover 5 questions in it. And in this way, in each topic we cover 5 questions every day. So if we will continue to do so till 31st May, because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC Civil Services, and we will end this series only one day before your exam. So in a way you can imagine that approximately 1000 questions will be covered if you follow us daily of each topic. For example, of only Ancient India you will be covering 1000 questions, and in similar way of other topics. For example, of environment, already we are on the lecture number 48. So that in that manner we will be doing a lot of practice, and this will help you in tackling your prelims exam in a very effective way. So if you want to secure your prelims, do follow us regularly and do subscribe to our channel. So let's see what is in the lecture. So first question is related to, with reference to temple architecture in Ancient India, consider the following statements. First is, the Amma shrine to house the image of chief goddess emerged as a feature during Chola period. Second is, Visara style of temple architecture emerged during Chalukyan period. So let me tell you friends that this Amma shrine to house the image of chief goddess, it doesn't emerge during Chola period, it emerged during the period of Vijayanagara Empire. So in that period there was a kind of Amma shrine in which the chief goddess was placed. And similarly, the second statement is Visara style of temple architecture emerged during Chalukyan period. So yes, this statement is correct friends. Visara style, actually it is a hybrid of Nagara and Dravidian style. The Nagara style of temple architecture is prevalent in North India, and the Dravidian style is prevalent in South India. So the hybrid of it is Visara style of temple architecture, which gained prominence during the Chalukyan period, and Badami is its the Badami is an important site for this architecture if you want to see the Visara style of temple architecture. So this is about the first question. So let's move on to second question. The second question is, inscription of which of the following rulers can be found on Allahabad pillar. So you know about Allahabad pillar friends, it is quite popular. So if you don't know, then we will be in few minutes we will be knowing about it. So it is a quite popular pillar. So we have been asked that inscriptions of which rulers are there on this pillar. The first is Ashoka, second is Samudragupta, third is Jahangir. So let me tell you friends that all these three have their inscriptions on the Allahabad pillar. So first of all, the pillar was ordered to be made by the Ashoka, the emperor of Mauryan Empire. So during his reign, this pillar formed, and on it he inscribed his edicts, and he kind of to popularize Buddhism. And after that, Samudragupta inscribed on it through Harisen, and it basically eulogizes the Samudragupta's achievements. And after that, Jahangir to commemorate his accession inscribed on this pillar. So this pillar has the inscriptions of three rulers. So we have to choose the correct code. So correct code is D, that is 1, 2, and 3. So friends, the answer is solution D. So friends, we are not providing the explanation here. We have only provided the explanation of first question as is visible on your screen. If you want to get the explanation, then I will tell you the procedure. Then you can get the explanation of these questions also. Let's move on to the third question. Third question is, with reference to burial practices in stone copper culture, consider the following statements. First is burying of domestic dogs along with their masters was widely prevalent in Neolithic culture. Second is in Eastern India, fractional burial was prevalent. So we have to choose the correct statement regarding it. So let me tell you friends that if you have listened heard about if you have heard about the site of Burzahum or Gufkaral of northwest or northwestern part of Kashmir, then you might have the idea that there we have found the pit dwellings as well as the domestic dogs buried with their masters. So it was during it was a kind they both these sites are Neolithic sites. So first statement is correct. Regarding the second statement is also correct friends, because in Eastern India fractional burial was prevalent during the ancient time. So it is not friends a similar manner, it is not similar practice that everywhere the fractional burial was done. In Eastern India only it was done. So in Western India, for example, we found the complete extended burials. So this is the correct statement. Both these are correct. So the solution is C. So the detailed explanation that what are these sites and what are the different burial practices in different regions, that you can get in the explanation PDFs that we provide to you people. Next is fourth question. In the context of ancient India, what does the term Chakravartin imply? So we have to in the context of ancient India, we have to consider this statement. The A option is an in charge of transfers and promotions in the kingdom. B is the commander-in-chief responsible for war strategy. C is a king who established his kingdom on a very large part of Indian subcontinent. D is a researcher who studied the rotation and revolution of heavenly bodies. So friends, let me tell you that in the context of ancient India, the Chakravartin implied the king who had established his kingdom on a very large part of Indian subcontinent. So the correct option is C. Chakravartin, for example, Ashoka was referred to as Chakravartin because he had conquered large part vast swaths of Indian subcontinent. Similarly, Samudragupta is also sometimes referred to as Chakravartin in ancient Indian texts. So C is correct. So the solution is C. Let's move on to fifth question. Fifth question is, consider the following statements. The subject matter of a Ajanta painting is almost exclusively Buddhist. Second is both Hindu and Buddhist literature refer to paintings of various types. Three, mural paintings are mostly secular in nature. So we have to choose the correct statements. So let me tell you friends that the first statement is correct, that the Ajanta paintings have this almost exclusively dedicated to Buddhism. So they mainly depict the Jataka stories, that is the previous births of the previous birth stories of the Lord Buddha. So first is correct. Regarding the second statement is also correct. That is, both the Hindu and Buddhist literature refer to different kinds and techniques of paintings. And regarding the third statement, friends, third statement is incorrect because mural paintings are mainly religious in nature, but there are some secular mural paintings also. So the third statement is incorrect. So the correct statement is 1 and 2 only. So solution is B. So this is all about our today's lecture, that is of ancient India, and that you have got at exact 9 a.m. So friends, in this way we are covering all other series as well, and with proper timetable. We have started this practice from today onwards, that we will upload on proper time so that you can plan your study accordingly. So you can check the timetable in the playlists of our channel, and then you can plan your studies accordingly. You will exactly get the video at that time at which we have mentioned in the timetable. So there will be not a single minute above or below or up or below your time to your timetable. So you can plan your timetable accordingly and prepare for prelims. You can prepare for prelims in that manner. So friends, timetable is important, and that's why we have started this practice. So friends, the next thing is also important, that if you want to get the explanation PDFs, then you can WhatsApp us at 8968426481. So actually, why we included the explanation of first question, because we wanted to tell you that we are following the pattern of UPSC, that whether we are ex explanation our explanation is up to the mark of UPSC level or not. So for the purpose of your affordability, we have kept minimum charges for this explanation PDF. And let me tell you, before letting you know the charges, let me tell you that these explanations are much important for you. Because friends, at the end of the day, when your exam will be near, you will not be able to see the 15 to 20 minute long video, and in that time you will not have the also the time to read the bulky books, the like proper old NCERTs for the ancient India, or for that medieval India or modern India, because at that time you will have multiple topics to revise, the like economic survey, budget, and India yearbook and other things. So at that time you must have some kind of thing in which by following which you can revise your basic concepts quickly. So these explanation PDFs are designed in this manner. So they are also not monotonous, because when you read NCERTs or standard books, you at the most you can read them two times. After that they become boring. So you can't find interest in them. So but in case of UPSC, the revision is the most important thing. So if you want to do the revision in a proper manner, because this will ultimately decide your selection, so you obviously you have to revise. So if you want to revise in an effective way with minimum loss of time, then you can subscribe to our explanation PDFs, which are kind of the explanations to the questions. So friend, you let me also tell you one thing, that UPSC is not about just questions and answers, seeing their answers. It is it can be this strategy can be possible in SSC and all other basic exams, but in UPSC you must have your facts and concepts cleared. So you must remember the facts also, as well as you must have the clear concepts. So for that you must need the explanation of the PDF of the questions. For example, consider this fifth question. So obviously Ajanta paintings is about Buddhist paintings. So I have told you that these are about Jataka stories. So you must also know that what are these, what is the status of these, whether they are UNESCO World Heritage Site or not. And also, for example, mural paintings are secular in nature, then what is mural painting, you must know about it. And also what are the famous mural paintings that are in India. So these things are important from your prelims point of view. So rather than wasting time and searching them on Google, we provide you the complete explanation in the explanation PDFs. So we are charging you people minimum amount. For example, I have included the picture of our series that we have started on our channel. For example, environment, we are charging you just rupees 50. Friends, this is not the cost of one explanation PDF. Let me tell you that this is the complete cost of all the explanation PDFs that you will be getting till 31st May. For example, already we are on the lecture number 48 of environment. So we will cover the environment till 31st May. So you can see that approximately 150 to 180 lectures will be covered. So that you can see that you are getting these explanation PDFs in just rupees 50. So that is not worth even one PDF explanation PDF is not worth 1 rupees. So you can see that how much affordability we are offering to you people. So in this manner also we are offering you the ancient India PDFs, complete PDFs, including the previous as well as forthcoming lectures at just rupees 100. And similar are the costs for different topics, you can see them. But if you want to buy the complete package, then complete package total amounts to 950. But the complete package, we are giving you the complete package in rupees 800, that is at a discount of rupees 150 on complete package. So if you want to subscribe to them, you can WhatsApp us at this number, that is 8968426481. So this is all about friends today's lecture of ancient India. Thank you. And friends, lastly, do follow our channel, and please do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications about the updates that we do on YouTube. So thank